आई एम गोइंग टू डू फ्रॉम द फोर्सेज ऑफ चेंज फ्रॉम चैप्टर नंबर वन व्हेन वेयर एंड हाउ. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू नो वट वेयर द फोर्सेज वट वेयर द फोर्सेज दैट वेयर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द चेंज that characterize the modern age. That means the features of the modern age that we could see, what were the forces that are responsible behind it. Number one is your Renaissance. Number two, industrial revolution. Next, American and French revolutions, and finally nationalisms. So these are the forces of change. Number one, we are talking about Renaissance. Now what is this Renaissance? This is a movement that started in 14th century. In Italy. This word Renaissance, that actual mean means the literal meaning is rebirth. That means rebirth. It has started from 14th century and ended, continued up to 17th century. That means rebirth means what type of rebirth? Rebirth of thinkers. They will not take birth again. No, not that. That means the thinkers at that period will discover, will revive, will reconcile some of the learnings of the ancient Greeks and Romans. That gives us, that gives this Renaissance, this particular Renaissance, that gives the rise of scientific method of inquiry. What is this scientific method of inquiry? That means where we could do learning by questioning, observation and experimentation. Not only this, it encouraged people to think for themselves and question old beliefs and superstitions. That means day by day, when they have come to know about scientific method, when they have come to know about the learnings of ancient Greeks and Romans, they become encouraged people, they by themselves encouraged people, and they asked the other caste people or other higher caste people of the beliefs, old beliefs that they follow, or the old superstitions that they follow. Next comes our Industrial Revolution. Now Industrial Revolution was totally on economic revolution. It's an economic revolution started in Britain around 1750s. Here we will be knowing about some explorer, Vasco da Gama, Columbus. They discovered the sea route to the east and to the Americans, and it happened during 15th and 16th century. This particular thing, this had led to the expansion of trade. How expansion of trade? Now you see, when foreign people started coming to India or coming to new lands, what happened? They settled there, they took some information, they also stay there, they make markets by themselves, and then they stay here, live like us. So this is how the trade expanded. When they will go back to their place, they will talk about our country and they will again came back to sell something. So like this way, the trade will go on increasing. More products will grow. Old domestic system of artisan working at home, simple tools were replaced by factory system. So due to these all, some result has occurred, and that result is colonialism. Now, in colonialism, what happens when they don't get any place, when the foreign people or the outside people, they come and stay here, make their living. So acquiring other countries and dominating and showing power, that's called our colonialism. So this is what our colonialism, and it happened only because of the result of industrial revolution. Factory also needed raw materials like cotton, iron ore, coal. Now this prompted Britain and other European countries to search overseas for colony. That means the factories needed these raw materials. What are those? Cotton, iron ore. These are really important for them. And when they have not got all of these things in their country, they started searching these all overseas. And then only they made colonies. These colonies are as a market for the finished goods. That means whatever goods will be finished, that will be sold in the market, and as a source of raw materials too. Finally, we are going to talk about American and French Revolution. This has given us some ideals. What are the ideals? Liberty, equality, and fraternity. So liberty means what? Liberty means to give freedom to everyone. Equality, all are same. Is it Hindu? Is it Muslim? Is it Christian? All are same. And fraternity means brotherhood. Fraternity means brotherhood. So this revolution led to the growth of another powerful movement. So this revolution, this American and French Revolution, this has led to another important powerful movement, and that is nationalism. It is a strong feeling of love. It is a strong feeling of love, pride, loyalty that people have for their country. And not only that, it inspired many people in the late 19th century to fight for independence from British rule.